Just long story short, this ninja is easily above average, has a very strong dragon slash, very useful against bosses and mist monsters, and the throwing stars are pretty top of the line. Yo, what is up? Demonjoefrance here. Welcome back once again to another video. How are you guys doing? Guys, today we're going to be doing a review on the Cloaked Shadow Ninja. And this is a ninja that I've been meaning to do a review on. We did a whole live stream on it a while ago, but I've really just been wanting to cover the more new and interesting content. You know, this is just a reskin of a already in the game Skirmisher Ninja, which you can actually check through the collection book. The Skirmisher Ninja is right here, so this is really nothing new. I did do a review on Krampus, however, just because that he looks very unique, and you know, he's also a very new subclass, but the Skirmisher Ninja has actually been around since like launch of the game. So I decided that I would wait before I came out with a review on him, because he's obviously been in the game for a while, there's tons of new content to cover in the game and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, we basically just been covering the weapon sets and some of the new heroes, but this guy is just a reskin. But I do want to make a video on this guy. I want to get out some really good information out there and kind of show you guys what the Skirmisher Ninja is good for, because there's a lot of hype surrounding this hero because of the way that he looks, and he's honestly one of my favorites as well because of the way that he looks. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into this. Let's go ahead and take a look at his perks, his traits, and all that kind of stuff, and yeah, let's determine if he is a good ninja or not. So first up, obviously he is a skirmisher, he is a reskin, nothing new. He comes with shinobi just like every single ninja in the game. He has throwing stars, which throwing stars are actually really good on this ninja. We'll kind of get into that as we go down a little bit more. He's got Mantis Leap, which allows him to double jump. He's got Train Throw, which reduces the energy cost of throwing stars by 15, which is pretty good. He's got Cascade. The ninja throws one additional throwing star on the third toss, which, you know, he's going to throw one, and then two at the same time. He's got Dragon Slash, and this is mainly where this hero shines, is with his Dragon Slash, but we'll get to that at the way bottom of the perks. Then we got Wings of the Dragon, which increases the length of the Dragon Slash by one tile, which is good. We got Rain of Death. The ninja throws one additional throwing star on the second toss, so he throws one, then two again. Then we got Return of the Dragon, reduces the energy cost of Dragon Slash by 15, which is very good. We got Crescent Kick, which is a very near just worthless ability in my opinion. You know, it's really good in case like somebody's like really up on you, like a blaster, and it's about to kill you. You know, you can just like slap it with your ankle and then you're good to go. But that's the only other time I could really see Crescent Kink being useful. You know, maybe if there's a group of huskling around you or something like that, then it might be useful. But aside from that, just Crescent Kick, I'm really not too big of a fan of. Then we got Piercing Stars, which is very good for the throwing stars. Throwing stars pierce up to 3 targets, and this is going to allow you to kill multiple enemies at the same time, especially if they're in a trap tunnel. Otherwise, you know, you have to line up your shot or whatever. And then we have, or your throw. And then we have Tail of the Dragon, and this is one of my favorite perks on any ninja. This comes with Dire as well. He is the Mythic Wolf, and you know, this is basically going to allow a trail of energy to be right behind your Dragon Slash whenever you use it, and this can be used for a lot of different things. It damages for up to 12% of the Dragon Slash damage for every half second, and it slows the enemy by 30% whenever it's caught within the tail for 3 seconds. Overall, whenever it comes to this ninja, Crescent Kick just might as well be ignored, and he is really going to shine with his throwing stars and with his Dragon Slash. Unlike the Dragon Ninja is just 100% Dragon Slash. This guy is kind of a mixture of throwing stars and Dragon Slash. So the build that we went on this character, as we went with Blazestorm Enforcer for the 20% extra ability damage, the Shuriken Master as well will allow you to have more ability damage, and then we went with Urban Assault, which is going to allow our throwing stars to do extra headshot damage because we already have some crazy buffs going towards the throwing stars, so this is going to be on top of that. And so for the mission that we're going to be running in today's video, it's going to be just me and my friend Nylik, and we're going to be running this Evacuate the Shelter level 100. We're going to kill some husks at the beginning, see how much work we can do, and then do a little bit of a smasher test, and then wait to the end of the mission and just go ham with this ninja. So without further ado, I will see you guys on the battlefield. Alrighty, boyo, so here we are in game. Normally whenever I am playing the Cloaked Shadow Ninja, I like to run two weapons in particular. I like to run the Hemlock because just obviously it's such a strong weapon, and I like to run the Ginger Blaster. And honestly, since he is a ninja, we probably could get away with using a 6 feet under as well, just in case we have flingers later on in the future. But I love the Mantis Leap with the Ginger Blaster. It's just really strong being able to hop all over the place and be able to kill mist monsters and such. So I really, really, really do like this Ginger Blaster. Hopefully we can get a decent amount of enemies to like hurry up and spawn. Recently, whenever I've been doing reviews and stuff, it just kind of takes a minute. So I guess we'll just kind of wait a little bit. All right, so I think we got a few of them to spawn. We got a bad boy over here. Really not too many enemies. Yeah, this is actually part of it. So not too many enemies. But I guess it's not really going to be too difficult. It is just me and Nihilic, and I do remember that they did nerf the missions and kind of made them easier for whenever you have less people. Oh, dude, this freaking Dragon Slash is nasty, dude. So yeah, I guess that was the pitiful wave of enemies that we had. So I guess without further ado, we will go and try to find a Smash. Oh, there he is right there. Yeah, there's a Smasher right there. So we are going to test out the abilities and whatnot on this Smasher bud. Try to kill his little minions off to the side, get him out of the way. There we go, kill that bad boy right there. Okay, come here, Smashy boy. I'm gonna get some headshot throwing stars on you so I can show you guys how much the throwing stars would do in terms of damage. So there you go, there is the throwing star damage. That is about maybe 20%. Now I just shot him and put vulnerability on him. No. Okay, come on. He's about like, I don't know, 60% health. I want to wait for that debuff to go away. So I'm going to kill these boys right here. Kill you. All right, debuff is gone. So let's go and Dragon Slash this boy. Come here. I did want him to rush at me so we could see how slowed he got. But there he goes right there. You can also see he's taking a little bit more damage. Throw some more throwing stars. And then we can finish him off like that. So the damage is actually pretty decent, and the utility is there as well. If you do have a Smasher that is rushing at you, you are going to be able to kind of slow him down a little bit as far as the Dragon Slash is concerned. And that's pretty much with any enemy, but I normally find the most use out of it with a Smasher, and especially like something like a mini boss as well. It's just really freaking nasty. We can showcase the way that the throwing stars, I keep wanting to call them shadow stars, the throwing stars can work. So if we kind of line these guys up right here, as you guys can see, we just killed three husks just like that, no problem. I've actually was able to kill three blasters before off camera after getting their health low, which was really freaking cool to be able to kill three mist monsters with one ability. We can showcase it here as well if we can line up these enemies right here, throw them like that. So as you guys can see, we damaged him, him, and him all at the same time. Do a little bit of a Dragon Slash. As you can see, that guy was taking a little bit of damage. And just, yeah, the abilities on the Cloak Shadow are very, very, very useful, in my opinion. You're able to get those piercing throwing stars, which are very useful in certain situations, especially on weaker husks. You can kill a pretty big group of them pretty easily, especially if your Dragon Slash isn't up. And then you can use your Dragon Slash for groups of enemies. You can use it for individual smashers. You can use it for mini bosses. The fact that the Dragon Slash has the little trail like this can be used for so much stuff. So I think we're going to go ahead and fast forward to the gameplay. If I do find another Smasher, then I will show you guys a little bit more level 100 Smasher gameplay. But yeah, I don't really think we need too much more of that, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward on to the actual nitty-gritty, and I'll see you guys in just a moment. Alrighty, boyo, so the shelter has just charged, and I can already see a big old smashy boy right out there. We got some enemies spawning over here, which we can do a little bit of a damage to. Actually, wow, that freaking trail actually did a lot more damage than I figured it would to these boys. Can we do another one? Come on, let me Dragon Slash. Ugh! I really do like the Dragon Slash on this ninja. So yeah, I'm not sure how many reviews of the Cloak Shadow are out currently. I haven't really been paying attention to YouTube. I normally don't even watch YouTube in my free time. Normally I'm watching Twitch, I'm watching live streams and stuff like that. So I'm not sure what other people's opinions are on this ninja, but I do want to make my opinions very clear on how I feel on this ninja, and that's that this ninja is above average, easily. Above average is how I would label this ninja in terms of like a number out of 10, honestly. I would probably give this ninja probably a 7, maybe 7.5 out of 10. I think that that ability right there with the Dragon Slash is just enough reason to even want to use this ninja. Not only do you get a ninja that is probably the coolest one in the game, arguably, in terms of the way that he looks, but you're also getting one that comes with a very good Dragon Slash and a very good Throwing Star kind of setup, you know what I mean? If you are going to go with Throwing Stars, honestly, I think Skirmisher is the way to go. I don't know everything about ninjas, so there honestly could be a ninja out there with better Throwing Stars. But even if there is, I believe that the Throwing Stars that you get on the Skirmisher in particular actually do make him worth using over any other ninja. You know, that combined with the Dragon Slash is just really, really good. And unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get a mini boss in this, in this gameplay and whatnot, but you guys are able to see, you know, how exactly it works on Smashers and whatnot. We're actually going to shovel this boy because of the memes. Come on, just die. Just Crescent Kick as well. And just one more slap. There we go. but yeah, you guys are able to see how it performs, you know, against Smashers and whatnot. So you can only imagine, you know, how good it's going to be against Myth Monsters. Not Myth Monsters, against mini bosses and stuff. Because, you know, I wish I could have got better gameplay for you guys. Unfortunately, the server reset, so we do have to do, like, you know, just this regular evacuate the shelter. And there's not as many enemies that you can test stuff on. But, you know, you can get some... Oh, yeah, right here, actually. Speaking of the freaking devil. That's actually a perfect little area right there to showcase some gameplay at. But, yeah, the alerts actually just reset whenever we went to go record. So, unfortunately, we weren't able to get anything good because, you know, it was either going against a nature storm or it was going against... it's either a nature storm... Or it was a healing death burst or, you know, something stupid like that. And healing death burst just takes away the whole purpose of Dragon Slash if everything's just going to get healed as and when you use it. So I figured that, you know, we would opt for this gameplay right here. Even though not as action-packed, it actually kind of makes it a little bit more... You can kind of observe the damage you're doing a little bit more to enemies because there's, you know, just less going on right now. But yeah, that right there, you know, is already slowing him, doing damage to that guy right there, making him slower. And just all sorts of cool stuff. So I really do like this ninja. I actually just stunned that boy because of his propane. I actually do like this ninja. And you guys know me as somebody that really doesn't like ninjas all that much. You know, mainly I'm just kind of like a soldier and outlander guy. But at the end of the day, the Cloaked Shadow Ninja is probably one of the better ninjas out there. Easily above average and easily one of my favorites, not only for his looks, but you guys know that whenever I did that dragon or that dire review, that the Dragon Slash definitely stood out to me. But I think honestly that's probably the most that I can talk about this ninja. I really don't want to waste your guys's time and stuff in this video, so I think I'm gonna end the gameplay a little bit early, kind of like I did with my Krampus video. Just long story short, this ninja is easily above average, has a very strong Dragon Slash, very useful against bosses and Myth Monsters, and the Throwing Stars are pretty top of the line. So that's pretty much all I really got to say about this ninja, and I do want to hear your guys' opinions in the comments down below of what you guys think about the Cloaked Shadow. You guys already know mine, so I might as well know your guys's. And I do want to hear some good points, you know, for those of you guys that do like ninjas and dislike ninjas, why or why not you would use this hero. And yeah, but that's pretty much it for me. That is all I really got to say about this ninja. Don't want to waste any more of your guys' time, but thank you guys so much for watching. I greatly do appreciate it, and I will see you guys next time.